Everyone, myself Dr. Kamaljit Singh from DAV College Nakodar. You all are welcome to the YouTube channel of KRM DAV College Nakodar, DAV Digital Pathshala. And here today we will discuss the topic for BCom students, and the topic is foreign exchange risk and exposure. Particularly, I will mention here foreign exchange exposure because in the last lecture, we already discussed foreign exchange risk. You know, any company which is importing or exporting has to deal with foreign exchange. So there are risks and exposure relating with the foreign exchange. There may be changes in foreign exchange rate, and it will lead to economic exposure, translation exposure, transaction exposure. Accordingly, different companies or firms, they try to hedge, they try to protect their risk and uncertainty. Now, let us try to explain these exposures in detail. Foreign exchange rate risk and exposure can be categorized into two categories. One is accounting exposure, second is economic exposure. Accounting exposure can be further subdivided into translation exposure, transaction exposure. And economic exposure can also be categorized into two subparts, transaction exposure and operating exposure. Now let us have its detail one by one. These are some technical terms. In this particular section, we are going to discuss the meaning of these terms and then types of exposure and its measurement. Now, foreign exchange exposure. Firstly, what does it mean? Due to change in foreign exchange rate, what will be the impact on firm's potentiality regarding market value of the firm, regarding profitability of the firm, and net cash flow of the firm? So, what will be the impact of foreign exchange rate change on these three things concerning firm, that is termed as foreign exchange exposure? Now, its first type, accounting exposure. Accounting exposure can be defined in this way, that is, it is the impact on firm's financial position due to its past actions regarding foreign exchange rate movement. We will discuss its detail in transaction and translation exposure further. Now, what is economic exposure? Economic exposure is nothing but the future impact of foreign exchange rate movement on firm's financial position. Now, the difference is that in accounting exposure, we are seeking the impact on firm's financial position due to past actions, but in economic exposure, we are talking about future impact and not past actions. Now, first type of accounting exposure is translation exposure. Now, this translation exposure is also called balance of payment exposure or sometimes balance sheet exposure. It means the change in the value of outstanding financial obligations of the firm due to change in foreign exchange rate. Let us take an example. Suppose X subsidiary of India is working in USA. Its assets value is $1 lakh with spot exchange rate of rupees 70 per dollar. It means 70 lakh rupees in India. After 1 year, assets value rises to 1.01 lakh with spot rate 69 rupees, or you can say 69.69 lakh in India. So the difference between 70 lakh and 69.69 lakh is 0.31 lakh. This is called translation loss. Similarly, there can be translation gain also. We can explain translation exposure with the help of this diagram also. Let there is one parent company operating from USA. Its head office is in USA, but its subsidiaries are operating in India, Japan, France, and Australia. Now, in India, subsidiaries' accounting statement, financial statement will be in terms of rupees. Subsidiary operating in Japan, its financial statement will be in yen. Subsidiary C operating in France, its financial statement will be in euro. Similarly, any subsidiary of this parent firm operating in Australia, its financial statement will be in Australian dollar. Now, all these four subsidiaries, their consolidated financial statement will be prepared in the parent firm in USA. So, during these preparations, there can be translation loss or risk called translation exposure. Now, let us come to second type of exposure of accounting sense, that is transaction exposure. This exposure comes both under economic and accounting sense. Now, its meaning is that transaction exposure arises because of uncertain contractual obligations. It is the impact on cash flow due to existing contractual obligation, because firm may have contractual obligations, and when exchange rate changes, it will affect the outstanding obligations of the firm. We can explain it with the help of an example. Suppose US company is operating in France. Company has raised loan from France bank in terms of euro, but wants to repay it in terms of American dollar from home, that is parent firm country. Now, dollar euro ratio, it may change. It is uncertain whether dollar will appreciate or euro will appreciate. We can't determine in the future. It is uncertain. This uncertain contractual obligation will result into transaction exposure. It can be measured as the difference between accounts receivable and accounts payable denominated in foreign currency. For example, US firm will denominate the receivable, account receivable and account payable in terms of finance euro, and it will yield what is called transaction exposure. Now, it has three components. One is quotation exposure, second is backlog exposure, third is billing exposure. I have mentioned here T1 minus T2. T1 is quotation time when quotation is invited. T2 is contract time when contract between the two parties made. The difference between these two is called quotation exposure. Now, when contract is made, then next step will be to file order. So, order time and contract time gap, that is called backlog exposure. Now, when any order is filed, but there will be a time to get the payment, this is called difference between T3 and T4. So, this difference is called billing exposure. When you will add these three exposure, you will get what is called transaction exposure. Third is operating exposure, also called economic exposure. Now, economic exposure is nothing but the impact of foreign exchange rate changes on future expected cash flow of the firm. So, if foreign exchange rate changes, how future expected cash flow they will be impacted is termed as economic exposure. We can explain it with the help of an example. Suppose an Indian firm is importing raw material from United States. Price of raw material has increased in United States. So, it means cost of production of Indian firm will also rise. Now, firm will have to decide about whether to increase the price of the final product or keep it constant. Such like impact is called operating exposure or economic exposure. Here, operating exposure deals with change in future cash flow due to unexpected change in the exchange rate. So, it is not concerned with past actions of the firm, but future cash flow changes. Now, last is methods to measure transaction exposure. Broadly speaking, there are four methods. One is current non-current method. Second is monetary non-monetary, temporal and current rate. In current method, we use present rate of exchange. But in non-current method, we take its average or historic rate of exchange to convert assets and liabilities from one currency to another currency. In monetary case, we take cash, account receivable, account payable, debts as on current account. But in on non-monetary, we take fixed assets, inventories to be converted on historic rate of exchange. Now, temporal method is nothing but the monetary method, but the difference is that in monetary method, inventories are taken into non-monetary way, that is converted in historical rate, but in temporal, these inventories are treated as monetary asset, so they are converted into current rate. Last is current rate. Here all statements are converted at current rate, so it is conventional account sense. Thank you.